which says it's Uday Ved for tax and other implications, partner at KNAV Chartered Accountants. Aarti Chairath, welcome to the studio. Jivya Shastri joining us. I have with me Lalita Kumar Mangalam. Thank you very much, Lalita, for staying on for a little
bit.
Nice
to be here.
Thank you. It's nice to see you as well. And should we start? Uday, what can we expect in terms of tax concessions on the taxation front, on the personal income front? What should we expect? How will this affect inflows for the people of this country? Uday.
Okay. Thanks, Arnab. Clearly, this is not a vote on account, as I think indications are very clear. It's an interim budget. And so it would certainly, if that's the case, there would be taxation proposals, as we call it in the part B of the budget speech. I think in order to make it more for the common man, a key would be whether the exemption limit would be raised from 2.5 lakhs to maybe all the way up to 5 lakhs. Personally, I feel 5 lakhs, I think, is a high limit. Here is a case where the government wants to increase the tax base, so you generally don't want people to go out of the tax net. Having said that, Finance Minister did it very smartly 2 years back. When for the 2.5 lakh to 5 lakhs, the tax rate was reduced from 10 to 5%. Okay, that gave a lot of relief. And if you look at the ATC limit of insurance premium and provident fund, etc., 2.5 lakh anyway goes to 4 lakhs. Plus, you have a standard deduction for the employees, it goes to 4.4 lakhs. So I think rather than increasing the exemption, maybe a good thing in my view would be to raise the standard deduction from 40,000 to 1 lakh. I mean, that really will help the salaried class people. That is one. And certainly 2.5 lakh limit can go to up to 3 lakhs, 3.5 lakhs. That would add more money to the common man, and that will come in the way of bringing more money into the economy by higher spending.